Aloha and welcome to the Wild Wahine. This is Kehlani and this video is 5 things you can expect from a tarot reading from me. So there are a lot of tarot readers out here. Many of them are very wonderful, but I wanted to express what are some of the things that make me unique as a tarot reader if you would like to work with me. So tarot reading is one of those things that people have a lot of different feelings about. Some people are really excited to get a reading, some people are a little bit scared, some people are kind of ambivalent to it. I use tarot in my daily practice and I've been doing it for years and years and years. It helps me gain clarity, it helps bring a little bit of resolve to situations that sometimes I have a difficult time, you know, making a choice in, and that's largely what a lot of people come to me for. A lot of times they're not really exactly sure what's going on, their lives can be a little bit on fire, or they're excited about something and they have 2 different options and they don't know which one to choose. So a lot of times when people come for a tarot reading, they're in an acute situation, their emotions are very high, and they're trying to decide what they want to do with their life. Or they're kind of like lumping around through life and they're like, I'm feeling uninspired, I don't know what to do, I have no idea what's going on, help. So if you're any one of those things or anything in between the middle, or if you were gifted a reading, which happens a lot and people are like, I don't really know, just tell me what's going on, we can work with that too. Essentially, what we're doing is we're using cards to help guide and give you insight and give you information. So the very first thing that you can expect from a tarot reading from me is to gain insight. And so I'm actually going to use tarot cards to help explain this. And the first card that I'm using is the Queen of Wands. So for the Queen of Wands, and how I like to embody that type of energy, since I happen to be like a very solar person, it's insight, it's illumination, it's reflection, the reflecting of light. When you have light, you are able to see clearly where things are. That's literally what clairsentience is, to see things in a clear way. Clairaudience is to hear things in a clear way. So there's a certain level of clarity that you can expect when you're getting a tarot reading from me. We dig deep into the cards. We answer the questions that you have. If you don't have questions and you just want a kind of general idea, we can go through that too. But of course, I always encourage people to ask questions, because when you ask questions, you tend to get more specific answers. So we go in depth with what's going on. There's a lot that comes with that. There's a little bit of storytelling and some archetypal work that comes with it. You know, it is a back and forth type of situation. I love to work with people like that. It's a little bit different than what you see, and maybe that a lot of other people do, where it's just like, here are your cards, this is what's going on, and that's it. I really like to have a discussion with things. I do the exact same thing when I'm doing astrology with people, where I like feedback from my clients in terms of what the cards are saying, so then I can go deeper with what the meanings will mean to them. So it really is a relationship that I like to have when I read with people, and it makes them feel a lot more comfortable, and I think you get a really clear, very accurate reading that you can walk away with feeling empowered to make whatever choices that you want to make. The second thing that you can get when you book a reading with me is to get straight talk. And for that, I picked the Queen of Swords. So yes, this is deeply important. I am not a love and light and light and love kind of person. I think that's great if that's what you do. And I do believe in love and light, of course, but I do understand that there's a shadow. And I do understand that sometimes things that come up in a reading, they're not necessarily always going to be of the love and light kind. Sometimes they're a little bit deeper. Sometimes they can be shadowy. Sometimes they can be a little bit scary. But I definitely promise that I will always tell the truth and I will always tell you what I see and give you some insight into what I see, and say that in a very clear way. I think that's deeply important whenever you're working with somebody. Remember, a lot of times people come into readings and they've had like a lot of things going on. There's shadowy things happening. People are not always telling them the truth. They feel in the dark about a lot of things. So I'm here to help shed light on that. And so for me, it's very important to be truthful with what I see and to be honest with what I see. And that actually is better. It's kind of like, finally, when you know the truth of something and you're no longer in the dark, you can say, okay, this is what I'm dealing with. And now, you know, what am I gonna put in my arsenal? So I think truth is very empowering, and I think it's deeply important for all of us as readers. The third thing that you can expect when you get a tarot reading from me is support. And for that, I pick her, the Queen of Cups. So for the Queen of Cups is all about like intuition and support and nurturing. So I think like my whole life, I've always been the person that everybody comes to, like really even within my friend pool, with all of their problems and all of their issues, and you know, they need someone to hold space for them. And that's what this is. That's what your tarot reading is. It's the reader essentially holding space for you, saying, this is your time. This is the time that we're going to take a look deep into seeing what's going on with you. We're going to be using energies that we don't really exactly know where they come from, to be quite honest. And I mean, a lot of people have ideas, whether you're pulling from your higher self or gods, goddesses, is God or whatever it is, your ancestors, many different energies are at work here. But however it is, we're taking this sacred time, we're taking this sacred space to really focus on you and hold space in that sense. Now, oftentimes after reading, sometimes if people are still at a standstill or they're not exactly sure what to do or they have some work to do, I have been known to give homework. I don't always do it. You don't have to do it. But it is something that I offer, or give some journaling prompts or some meditations and stuff like that if I feel like it'll be helpful for the client, or especially if I have clients that are repeat clients that come to me, you know, because we're working together on a coaching type way and they really are trying to get somewhere else. There is some, you know, extra follow-up and extra care and extra comfort. So know that there's going to be straight talk, but there also is going to be like a lot of yummy space to hold for you as you're going through whatever it is that you're going through and whatever it is we're talking about. So the third thing that you can expect if you book a tarot reading from me is protection of your privacy. And for that, we have the Queen of Pentacles. So protecting what's important, which would be your information, which would be everything that you share. That to me is of the utmost importance. I do not share information. I do not share readings. I do not use people as examples if I'm teaching for someone else unless I get their permission first and it's okay. This is something that is pretty much straight through for my astrology, for my herbalism, for my tarot, for anything that I do with people or however I work with them. A lot of times people will like to have their readings recorded so that they can refer back to it sometimes, because some things come up and they're not happening right now, but they're happening in the future. And that's wonderful. I do record for people and they can keep it for themselves. And then I do not keep any of those recordings. Now, if I'm working with somebody on a one-on-one coaching type basis, I do jot some things down just as support to help them out, but that is all like encrypted and protected and all of that. So incredibly important. I do not believe in sharing people's information. Just something that I don't do. It doesn't matter who comes to me. If you love me and you tell your whole family they have to come see me, that's wonderful. And everybody in your family will have separate experience and no information will be shared. And that is how I roll. The fifth thing that you can expect if you get a tarot reading from me is to deepen your intuition. And for that, I pull this goddess, which is the High Priestess. So one thing that's really interesting that a lot of people don't know, when you start really like participating in divination, getting readings, having your astrological chart read and all of those types of things, or however you're working with your own practice at home, you will deepen your intuition. You will start to see some of the things that pop up manifest. You'll start to see triple numbers. You'll start to see some of the imagery and some of the archetypes that get pulled out in the card. You might see those in your life. So it's really a beautiful thing that when you start to open yourself up to the liminal space, you'll start to see those things coming to you as well. So it just happens to be like an extra boon, you know, you gaining your own clarity, your own information. You might want to buy a deck of tarot cards for yourself and pull one and see what they're like and see if you're pulling the same cards that you get a reading from and all of those types of things. You will definitely be a lot more open to spirituality and to things coming in and listening to yourself. A lot of times I have people come to me and they just feel like they're very quiet. They've lost their intuition. They don't know what's going on. They're very confused, especially if they come out of a difficult relationship or something like that, and they really just don't know what is north and south. And so having a reading is such a beautiful way to ground you, to get you listening to yourself again, because you're listening to yourself by the cards that are pulled for you. You can see what's there in front of you. And I often say for people when they get tarot reading, which is a strange thing to say, but it's not really, and most readers would probably tell you this, most of the time the cards that we pull are not a big surprise. It's not like we're pulling something that you didn't know, that you didn't like know somewhere deep in your heart. So even just in that, and cards that are being pulled, and you say to yourself, you get that look on your face that my clients get, which is like, oh yeah, I knew this. Like, I knew this was something that was important. I knew this was going to happen. I figured I was going to get that card. Absolutely, because you're in sync with it. And so you can just see the beauty in that. You can see the connection in that. And things are going to connect a lot more for you when you get a reading. So anyway, that is basically the five things that you can expect when you get a tarot reading from me. I can't say that you can expect that from everybody else, but you definitely can expect it from me. If you have any questions or anything like that, you can post them in the comments below. If you are interested in booking a reading with me, all of the information is in the comments below, or you can visit me at www.thewildwahine.com for all of that information. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. I have a lot of really fun, interesting content coming up, and I also do weekly astro chats and all that fun stuff. So I will see you in the next video. Aloha.